Hi, I'm Sandy Graffius, your county controller. I'm here tonight with Steve Gieringer.
Close enough. G-I-E Ringer.
Yeah, that's how he's teaching me to spell. No, exactly. It's Steve Gieringer. I'll stop screwing around. And he's from NHS, which is not National Honor Society.
Correct.
It's Neighborhood Housing Services. Did I get it right?
Correct. Neighborhood Housing Services of
Can't
Greater
Can't stand
Parks.
Myself. A couple
Excellent.
Months ago, or a couple weeks ago, rather, we had he and Ron Miller on.
Yes.
And there was so much I didn't cover that I asked Steve to come back. And
thank you.
By the way, he is a newbie.
Yes, I
He's
am.
He's been in office as the CEO, ED, chief honcho, Mr. Just, Swiss cheese himself.
Exactly.
Since August.
Since
which
August,
is the bottom
beginning
line.
Of August, yep.
So I promised him I wouldn't ask him anything difficult, and since I
Thank
don't know
you.
The programs that well, I can't do that, so isn't that very handy?
That's great.
I wanna just back up and say that you had been on the board of directors for a while, is that correct?
That is correct. For about 7 months, I would say.
And when they did a search for a new CEO,
yes.
They tapped you because you were just so loaded with new ideas.
It just seemed like it was a good fit
the next
the right
best
time.
Step for you.
Yeah, exactly.
And in the meantime, Ron has ridden off into the sunset.
That's correct.
To,
yep.
to return occasionally.
He has retired, yes.
To stick his nose in case he missed something.
Right.
That's what I plan to do when I get out.
Well, that's okay.
I'm just going to keep coming back
yep.
and sticking my nose
exactly.
in.
Exactly.
Now, on the National Housing Services themselves, let's back up a minute.
Okay.
I was under the impression that you went out and fixed up houses, and that's really not it. That's not the main thrust of the program. So let's start. I want to start first with the veterans because I want to get
sure.
that for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And with your veteran program, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, you went out and assembled a group of people. So let's talk about that.
Sure.
First.
That's Operation Renovation.
Right.
And
I'm going to get out my paper so that
that's
I can
good write. Because I'll
so
need
I,
it too.
Then I'll really look like I know what I'm talking about.
So with Operation Renovation, what we do is we tap our different lending partners in the area, pretty much anybody that would want to join us, and we put together teams as we target the veterans in the city that need help with basic repairs or some easy remodeling items, like say they need a handicap ramp or remodeling the bathroom to make it more accessible. Simple things like painting, exterior work, minor window replacement, things like that.
Do you do gardening?
Well, we try to stay away from gardening. I have a black thumb, so I really don't like to.
Oh my gosh,
get involved
I can honest to goodness, I can kill a cactus because I don't water it enough. When I was a kid, I killed a cactus, so right there I gave
exactly.
up the whole thing.
Exactly. So I try to stay away from the gardening if at all possible.
That would really be an ever.
That would be ongoing.
Keep on going back.
But we do have had, we've had in the past, we've actually in the 3 years we've done it, we've had some repeat folks that we couldn't do the entire project in the one session. So then we would go back the next year.
When you look for volunteers and when you look for money,
mm-hmm.
you go out to local businesses, I assume, and you say to them, in exchange for giving us a $10,000 donation.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We will feature you at the Phillies games. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
Do I have the right sport?
Yes, that's correct. We.
And you put for $10,000, you put the name up on the billboard.
Yep.
You ask them to speak to the group, the crowd,
mm-hmm.
before and after the game.
Sure.
And you also give them tickets.
Yes.
Now, when they give you $10,000, that does not go into your operating, that does not go into your budget to pay salaries and
That
rent.
Is correct.
That
it goes
strictly
for materials.
Okay. Now, at $5,000, you go back to the different businesses, and if mm-hmm. they give you $5,000, there's just a little bit less that they get for their $5,000. And once again, you're buying supplies.
Yes.
So you're buying paint, and you're buying brushes, and you're buying
yes.
ladders, and you're buying buckets.
Correct.
And then you have to find volunteers.
Yep.
Now, when they give you money,
mm-hmm.
are they also giving you staff that are going to volunteer to go out and do stuff?
Well, you know what?
Or do you go to two different companies
well, we can,
to do that?
But believe it or not, that's really where our partners get the most benefit. One of the things that I found amazing when I first got involved was the local partner banks that we deal with, like Santander and Wells Fargo and Fulton Bank and Customers Bank. We would get a great outpouring from them of people that wanted to volunteer.
Oh, really?
And they're, oh, please don't forget to call us next year. I mean, it's really that important.
So they're looking for a community service project.
Exactly.
For their folks.
Yep. So they'll contribute funds, obviously, to help us and to do the renovation work. But more importantly, the sense of community support and participation that their employees feel many times is a greater benefit to the organization than just giving the money.
And you know what? That becomes a team effort for that company, which lets their folks work together outside the workday and talk and interact and talk about their families. That's very interesting.
Yep.
When you get volunteers, let's say from one of the banks, and I realize we have different sized banks because Santander and Fulton, there's no comparison.
Right.
Do you get 40 volunteers or do you get 5?
You know, it depends on the community development person within the bank and how many folks that they have that can get away. It's a week-long process.
Oh, so
many
really?
Times,
so
yeah.
So they're giving up a whole week.
Well, not necessarily. They can be assigned to a particular property, and if it's an easy type of cleanup, paint, or rehab sort of thing, they can be done in a weekend.
Okay.
So we normally run it like the last week of June into over the 4th of July weekend. Our biggest contributor this year was Wells Fargo. And so there was actually like an opening ceremony thing that we did with them. And then at the end, we partner with the Fightin' Phils, the Reading Phillies, to do like an NHS night at the Reading Phillies. And then we can recognize all the folks, you know, and get them out on the field. And we have a little stand there. And I actually got to be on the radio during can you imagine?
Did they hire you then for a disc jockey?
No.
Because you have a really good radio voice.
Well, and people have said that. But I'm not quite that, I guess, good enough that they didn't ask me back.
Well, then don't give up your day job.
I won't.
Okay. Now, we're talking mostly about renovating on veterans' places,
yes,
right?
Yes, that's correct. That's what it's all about.
Okay. Do you also do renovations on senior citizens?
Absolutely. We've partnered with the city of Reading, and they have a special program federally funded. It's called the MSRP program. So that stands for Major Systems Repair Program. In the city of Reading, for the seniors, if they're 62 or older, there's really not much of a qualification. It's an actual legitimate grant. So this isn't something that they're going to pay back. The same thing with Operation Renovation for the veterans. They don't pay anything.
Now, before you go on, are the veterans just in the city or is that countywide?
It can be countywide, okay. but a majority of our veterans are coming from the city.
But our seniors are in the city.
The seniors, that part of it is with the conduit is the city of Reading that the funding comes through, comes from HUD. So it's managed by the city, and then we apply for the funds based upon what we project, how many programs or how many renovations or major systems we're going to be able to do for the year. We're actually right in the middle of that process now, putting together a strategic plan for 2018.
So what you're doing now is you're looking at the need.
Correct.
And trying to figure out a
and trying to match the funding, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the seniors and the vets mostly come from the city of Reading when you're going in and doing these renovations.
Correct.
Do you do things as minor as putting new screen in the screen door?
Yes, that would fall into the operation renovation. We actually prefer that type of fixer-upper, if you will.
Because it's down and dirty and you can get it done.
It's simple. Usually in an afternoon, you can get it done.
Yeah.
You know, you can put a coat of paint on, clean up the front a little bit for everybody, do some, you know, some minor. That was sort of the... A precursor to that was something called Operation Facelift. And in Operation Facelift, that was basically a cosmetic cleanup of a particular block. So we would use the volunteers and we would target one block, and that would be over a weekend, and we would basically clean up the entire block, you know, from the facade to touch up painting and weeding and cutting grass.
Even if you just did like... What's it called when you squirt water?
Or power washing, yeah.
Thank you.
Exactly. So we would do that too.
I'll do the demonstration.
That's okay.
And you try to figure out what I'm trying to say.
Okay. What was that? Was it like password?
It's a real challenge on this show,
no, this
isn't it?
This is awesome.
I don't know what to tell you. Now let's talk a little bit about this because I think these numbers are really kind of interesting.
Well,
let's start with 2015 and tell me what this is.
Sure. Well, in 2015, there were 31 projects that were identified or 31 veterans that we were able to help.
So now we're zeroing in on vets.
Correct. So this is the operation renovation.
Okay.
We had 262 volunteers. They anticipate that you know, a volunteer hour is anywhere from $18 to $22. If you do the math, that ended up being about 3,254 hours with a total value of benefit to the community of just over $73,000.
So you took the amount of hours the people worked, multiplied it times what you estimated
by the government estimate for volunteers.
A reasonable wage.
Correct.
And they ended up in 2015 supplying $73,000.
About $73,000
worth of value.
Worth of value back to the community. That's correct.
Now, in 2016, your numbers jumped dramatically.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about that.
Well, with that, they did a reach out program to faith-based entities.
Okay.
For
Justin Redding?
No, they actually came from across the country.
Really?
Yeah, so it was...
Do you have any idea, because I know you weren't there at this time, do you have any idea how on earth Reading's NHS tied into a nationwide program?
There's actually, I believe either through the city or through the county is, and we partnered with Alvernia. Alvernia actually put the students up. There was 425 of them.
Were they all kids?
They were all, I think between the ages of 16 and 20.
Wow.
I'd have to check with my
That's okay.
resource development
This
manager.
Is not a test.
No, I know.
All right.
But that was a great, that was a really great program because we were able to do 75 properties.
Wow.
And then the throughput or the benefit to the community was 262,000.
Just because the kids put in that many hours.
Just because the kids put in that many hours. Over 11,000 hours.
Now you said they come in from all over the country.
Yes.
Where'd they stay?
At Alvernia. They put them up in the dorms.
No kidding. So yep. It was during the summer.
Yes. And then part of the thing that they did for their,
credit.
Development program was they ran a food drive.
No kidding.
Yeah,
the kids while they were in Reading.
Exactly. So they would you would drop your food items off at Alvernia, and then they would distribute them. I believe they went to the food bank.
No kidding.
Yeah,
so while they were in town,
then
they
that was part of their
little
volunteer of a volunteer project. Yeah.
Working their little bones off
exactly.
their hands. They were out there collecting food for our food
Absolutely,
bank.
Absolutely, yes.
You know, one year I went down to, where the heck was I? New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
That was the last flood that we had. And
yeah.
there were other groups down there, faith-based groups, easy for me to say, faith-based groups down there, and there were a bunch of kids from Ohio. And in that same age range, in that 16 to 20-year-old age range,
yes.
and they were cleaning up the beaches because there was so much erosion and there was so much flying around
yes.
that ended up being buried in the sand. And they were out there with rakes and shovels,
yeah.
and they were staying the same place we were. And they came back one day and they said that they had unearthed a washer and dryer from one of the hotels. So can you imagine the magnitude of that
exactly.
that wind that it was blowing?
Yeah.
I mean, a washer's heavy.
Yep.
I mean, I try to just move mine when it starts rocking and I
right.
can't get the darn bugger to do anything.
Yeah.
I can't imagine the velocity getting that stuff out there in the sand.
Exactly.
And they worked 2 or 3 days in a row trying to clean up the beaches so that they could get their tourism back on
sure.
track again. So they were $262,000. Now, what are the chances of you applying for that again?
Oh, we'll definitely do it again this year. Probably in March and April, I call them the draft notices will go out.
Uh-huh.
So we'll be recruiting folks to participate. We'll reach out to all our partner banks again.
But hang on a minute.
Mm-hmm.
You think you can get these kids to come in from around the United States again?
We're going to try to do that again. Logistically.
How do you get into that? How do you
well, that I really don't know.
Well, because Alvernia did it.
Correct. Well, they house them. I would have to check for you and find out what the entity is that we use to draw on the students.
Boy, I'm sure that every community in the United States is out to get this gang of kids. Because they work like a little demon.
They did.
Okay, now that we've basically covered the vets and what we can do for them,
mm-hmm.
and the seniors and what we can do for them, now let's talk about the financing, because I think that's mm-hmm. the biggest thrust
sure.
of your program, rather than the
yes.
the fixer-upper piece.
Well, from our standpoint, we're what we call a full-cycle home ownership center. So we take folks that are interested in purchasing homes.
Now,
and
hang on.
Yes.
I'm interested in purchasing. How do I get a hold of you?
Well, you can stop by 213 North 5th Street, Suite 1030. We're in the Phoebe apartment complex. They're on 5th Street across from Fulton Bank on 5th Street.
Did that used to be the Y Missing Building?
Was the Y Missing Club. We're actually renovating the Y Missing Club where the gymnasium or the fitness center is.
Yeah, the kids coming in to help you.
No, we're using a contract. So,
if you want, I'll come down and paint woodwork. I'm really good at that. So, I just can't get back off the floor after I'm down there with my paintbrush. So if you'd have a block and tackle available to pull me up.
We can do that.
I'm only kidding. No, okay, so you're at 5th and Walnut.
5th and Walnut is correct.
And
That's our headquarters.
Okay.
The number is 610-372-8433.
We'll put that up again. 372-8433.
Yep.
We'll stick that up again. Now, if I say to you, okay, I want to be a first home buyer, because mm-hmm. you've got to be a first home buyer, don't you?
Correct. That's what we deal with, first time home buyers.
Because you want to have folks that are paying rent every month and mm-hmm. not getting anything back.
Correct.
Except a place to live.
Right.
And have them get a home and help them to finance a home and educate them.
Exactly.
So I'm going to call you up and I'm going to say, okay, I'm a first-time buyer. I'm interested mm-hmm. in buying a home. What happens? What classes do I go
to?
What we'll do is
we have a great program. It's called Fast Track. And what we'll do is we can have a group as little as 10 people or a group as many as 50 or 60 people. We'll get together on a Saturday. It's a full-day event. And you're going to get the benefit of our partner banks, our partner realtors.
Insurance
for homeowners insurance, and some construction folks will come in. And we take you cradle to grave what's involved in actually owning a home. You would be surprised how many folks that are first-time home buyers have no idea how to even do simple maintenance items.
So that's one
of the biggest benefits of what we do is we do a full range of everything you're going to come up against.
Well, the one thing you're going to run into is folks have no idea how to get a mortgage.
Exactly.
They have no idea how much to pay. They have no idea how to look for a house
and property taxes
that is not going to take so much maintenance that they have their monthly
yes.
payment, and then they don't have money left over to do the
repairs.
That
is correct.
So, do you have a list of houses that you can show them and say, this is available, this is available? Do you want to live in this community? Mm-hmm. Do you want to live in this neighborhood?
Well, what we do is it's an 8-hour program on a Saturday.
Okay.
And they'll get to talk to a bank representative that will go over how to open up simple things like how to open up a checking account and a savings account. Then we'll have a mortgage originator who will teach them the ins and outs of, well, what's a mortgage? How does that work? We'll have a realtor there. And the realtor will explain to them about simple tools to go online and look for homes in their area. And we'll work with them to show them what's available. Now, one of the things that we do is we also rehab properties that we get gifted to us from the city, from the county, from different lenders. And then we'll rehab that property with county or city funds, depending upon where it's located. And then we can offer that for sale to our folks that are in the pipeline. And it's also open to the general public, you know, to put an offer in. But that's the full cycle.
When you get these people for that 8-hour day, mm-hmm. and you say you can have anywhere from 10 to 50, mm-hmm. how many homes are you parceling out in a year? Do you have any idea?
Well, for the number of folks that we help, we counsel between 400 and 500 people a year.
Really?
Yes, and that's exclusive of those classes. So we have a very aggressive, what we call a one-on-one counseling session. Some of our lender partner banks, depending upon the loan program that they're going to put the customer in, requires different degrees or different levels of counseling.
Well, you also have to have a little bit of skin in the game. You ask them to have, what, $1,500?
$1,500, yep. And then we remember we were talking about, well, what happens if there's properties that are kind of, mm-hmm. and we need to have some repairs done? We will look at the property inspection report from the home inspector. And if we see things on there that we know are going to be a problem, like say they could annotate, hey, guess what?
A new septic system.
HVAC, for example. It's a 20-year life.
Right, HVAC is a heater and air conditioner.
Correct. So say that's at the end of its life expectancy. Maybe it has 2 or 3 years yet. We can stipulate as part of one of our closing cost or homeowners assistance loans, we can say, hey, we're going to set aside up to $3,000 as an escrow
Does that then become part of their mortgage payment?
Correct, and that would become part of the loan that we would offer to them.
When you have the bankers there for that 8-hour day, mm-hmm. depending on their wages, and I know that they have to work someplace at least 2 years, mm-hmm. in the same place so that you know that they have a track record for wages?
Well, it doesn't necessarily have to be 2 years in a particular area. It just has to be 2 years of employment.
Okay.
Now, if you're self-employed, you need to have 2 years of federal income tax returns. But if you say your family transfers here from Ohio, California, but you've been paying your taxes and you have tax returns, that's fine. People transfer in and out all the time. So it's not really a geographic restriction. It's more a time restriction.
And I think that you do not ever want to set anybody up for failure.
Never.
So if they don't have the wage that's going to cover the mortgage that they're looking at for that house,
correct,
then you'd steer them into another direction.
Correct. And there's some folks that won't qualify because their debt-to-income ratio, that's the percentage of their expenses
income
versus what income they take in, has to be at a certain level. And that's all mandated by the federal government. So we certainly, you know, we don't like to shoehorn anybody into anything. We want to make sure that they have enough funds after they make their mortgage payment and making
sure to live.
But more importantly, that they do have funds in the event that something does go. Say you need a hot water heater, or say the roof has a leak or whatever,
yeah,
and you're not, you know, I didn't put you in a home where I know that you're going to end up giving the home back to the bank because you simply can't afford to upkeep the property.
I noticed when I was looking over the brochures and that stuff that you had given me that you will do a second loan.
That's, yes.
For repairs.
Yes.
Side of their mortgage, and mm-hmm, let's say that second loan is to get a heating system or a new roof. That would then be financed for like 7 years,
right,
and your mortgage goes up to 30.
Correct. So they would have a first mortgage.
But you'd have both payments to make for that 7 years until you paid that off.
Correct.
But the ability is still there to let them make the repairs they need to keep them in their homes.
Exactly.
Now, do you have any financing that you come through on your own, or is it all your member banks that are carrying that?
Well, for the first mortgages, the primary 30-year mortgages, that's done by the partner banks. What we'll do is we'll fill in one of two pieces, something called a closing cost assistance loan. So that could be on the FHA side or on the conventional side where they just need to borrow the funds for closing costs. Or we do the home ownership program where that's called the HOP loan, where we can do the 20% down payment. And then we would put that escrow repair portion,
right,
in with that too. So if they had repairs, kind of like back in the olden days, going back to 2004 to 2008, the olden days, right?
That to me is like yesterday at my age.
In the older lending days, they used to do those piggyback loans,
yeah,
where you could do an 80-20. So you could do 80%, so you wouldn't have to pay the private mortgage insurance. Well, that kind of went by the wayside. Now, what we do is we've filled that need. So we assume the risk on the 20% side in a second mortgage, and the first lender then only has to deal with the 80%.
Okay. I want you to give the phone number again in case,
sure,
you can write that down, because we
thank
have
you
like 1 minute left.
Okay. 610-372-8433.
Now, remember, this is for first-time buyers.
First-time home buyers.
Or veterans or senior citizens over 65.
62.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, just made them older than they need
to be. That's okay.
And the seniors have to be in the city.
The seniors for the MSRP program, that is correct.
And the veterans can be anywhere
in the
county.
Can be in the county or the city, correct.
And then you will send in a team that you're getting from your bank partners,
mm-hmm,
to go in over some kind of a time limit and get it fixed up and then get back out again.
Correct.
Now, when you make these loans on your own, because you're talking about you're helping with the
20%, mm-hmm,
what's your payback rate?
The interest rates?
Does everybody pay back the loan to you?
Yes. Well, our delinquency. Our delinquency percentage is below 10%.
Really?
So for the demographics that we have,
so
it's acceptable.
So if it's below 10%, then you must be making very adequate decisions on who to help with
money. Well, that was one of the reasons why when I came here, because I have an extensive lending background and underwriting, so I can actually look at the files once they've already been underwritten and make sure that there's,
idea,
yeah, just to make sure there's something that might have got missed, correct.
Because once again, you do not want to help a family get into a house and the next thing you know, they're losing it.
Exactly.
I hate to tell you, but we're done. Thank you very much. I appreciate you
pleasure
being here.
My pleasure.
This is just so fun. It's called Speed Talking.
Yeah, that's
next
perfect
week, somebody's coming on County Connection. I forget who. I'm sorry. Goodbye. Thank you for joining us tonight. Goodbye.